black hoodie. I'm back cooking these goodies. Look at these views from cooking these foods. Yeah.
Today's subscriber sponsor request coming in hot down south from Georgia. Shout out Tanya Eller. We're going to make her favorite southern comfort dishes. Join me with this rather involved but will be delicious meal. Okay, so today's dish involves quite a few components, basically like three separate dishes. So we got like a main one and some sides. Water on. This is going to be for these potatoes here. I'm going to basically just like par cook these down to where they're a little bit ready to kind of smash. And then we're going to have those with some onion and some lima beans. And that'll be the first side. So we'll let these guys come up. Okay, so while those are rolling, we're gonna get our southern fried cabbage going. But we got some prep to do for that. All right, so let's half this bad boy first off. Making a single person portion. So we are going to just do half, and I'm sure half's gonna be quite a bit, but it will lose a lot of moisture and come down quite a bit when you're cooking it. So we will chop it into these, you know, general chunks. Not too big, maybe like an inch in the surface area. Almost just cut myself. Perfect. Okay, bowl of cabbage, nice and prepped. Okay, next up we're gonna need some green pepper, just diced up. Just like a nice little cubed up dice. This is going in with onions and some bacon and some sausage. See, no, not too big, not too small, just nice little chunks. All right, prep plate they go. Okay, we've got some mushrooms here. Gonna chop these guys up for the stroganoff that we're gonna make. That's the main element to this situation. Okay, mushrooms done just like that. And we're gonna need onions at a few points in this dish. So I'm just gonna make a nice big batch of diced up onions too. Now Tanya said there's bacon in this cabbage, and then I think that there could be sausage too. So I'm gonna put some sausage in this as well, just real quick. Not a lot, just gonna use up this last little bit I had in the fridge, may as well find some use for it. And I think some of these southern fried cabbages do have sausage in them from time to time, but I'm just gonna cube up a little bit of that to add in with the bacon, because why not? Okay, so we'll check on these guys. I think they're probably pretty close. I do want them like basically fork tender. So that'll be perfect right there. Pull those off, strain those off. Okay, so apparently you're supposed to use buttered beans for this recipe or lima beans as a substitute, but I got broad beans, which look like bigger lima beans. So I hope this works. I've never ever used these before in my entire life. I've never really been a person who includes beans in their food or diet very often. I don't know why, I just never grew up really in my house eating anything with beans. Just kinda never was a thing. So we definitely have to strain these off though. I've worked with beans in restaurants. I've made bean dishes, but we'll see. Oh yeah, that looks pretty similar to what I'm supposed to be using. I think that's pretty legit. So we got our little mini boiled potatoes here, and for the beans and potatoes and onions, all kind of like fried off in butter, I'm just gonna smash these down a bit and make them into like smashed potatoes when they're fried off. Should be pretty nice. I love potatoes like this. They get so crispy and amazing. So just like that, as you can see. Okay, we got some more Wawa at a roll and boil here. We gotta get our egg noodles prepped for when we throw together stroganoff sauce. Okay, so I have these nice little thin beef strips. I'm just gonna cut them down into even smaller strips. Pretty easy task. But I like to put them in the freezer, like I said, for just a little bit so that they firm up, because they, you know, they kinda, they're just easier to work with that way, you know? Just like this. Maybe half inch strips. So I'm just gonna pop these in the pan, because that's our next move, is to cook this beef. Okay, so probably like 7 minutes here in, and those are looking perfecto. Let's strain those off and get those into a prep bowl. That's right, I wrap sometimes. Okay, so here's the whole kit and caboodle, all prepped and ready, all the components for everything we're gonna need for our dishes. And I have a question for you guys. Do you enjoy the prep process and showing everything, or should I just start my videos from this point and then immediately start cooking and explain along the way? Let me know in the comments, because I've been debating this the whole time. I personally like the prep quite a bit, but at the same time, I don't know, maybe it's easier just like this. But let's go ahead and get cooking on these components. Okay, so let's go ahead and fire up this beef. I'm gonna hit it with some oil, a little dash of salt, of course. Work that oil around a little bit, just to evenly coat for even cooking all around that beef. Yeah, let's go ahead and work this around. Yeah, we got a little good little bit of color on there, just trying to get some browning on it. Okay, I'm just gonna put this off to the side for a minute. Okay, same pan, little deglaze. Onions. Mushrooms. A little oil again. Okay, a little bit of garlic in here. A little bit of flour to bring everything together. It's all kind of coming together, maybe like a little roux kind of deal. Beef broth. So mix that in a little bit, let that kind of come back up to a little simmer. Okay, we're back at a little simmer here, a little boil, coming with our cream. We'll just try and reduce this out. Okay, it's like the last of this tub of sour cream here. Gonna take some of the liquid from here. Minus the mushrooms, of course. Gotta have a little bit in there. And just pop a little bit of that into the sour cream so that we can temper the sour cream independent of itself, just so it doesn't curdle, right? So it doesn't split and get all chunkity on you. And then we work that into the mix. A little Worcestershire, squirt of Dijon mustard, salt, pepper. And bring back the beef. All right, let's get this cabbage dish fired up, a little medium heat. Got the bacon in the pot already. Checking in, looking pretty good, but still got a ways to go. All right, we're coming in close to where we need to be here, just another maybe minute or two. And then I'm gonna pull this off the bacon and try to reserve as much fat of the bacon in here as I can, because we're gonna add the bacon in back later after we cook down these veggies. That is what you're looking for. Okay, so into here, onion, green peppers, spin them around. And that nice leftover fat, sweat them out. Let's get them a little bit glistening first here. All that flavor, all that fat, all those bottom pan Maillards working into these guys. Delightful. Sausage. Smells so good. Can't wait to eat this one. Okay, cabbage in. gonna put that on like a medium, pop the top, and let the moisture come out of the cabbage. All right. Stewing down nicely. Moisture is releasing. Got all those good flavors working together. Not quite where we want it yet, but you know, halfway there. But looking delicious, smelling delicious, and stinking delicious like cabbage. You guys know what I mean. A little bit farty. Just dawned on me that I didn't put any garlic in. A little bit of garlic. At this point, it looks like we could go back in with our bacon. Drop the heat. Incorporate. And we pretty much got ourselves that dish sorted out. There you go. Southern fried cabbage. All right, time for these potatoes, beans, and onions. Heading into the home stretch here, ladies and gents. All right, let's get these crispies in. Or soon to be crispies, of course. Some of these beans in here. A little shake around just to get everything even. Let that side get crisp. Go for a toss. Go ahead and add in these onions. I'm just gonna add in a little bit of pepper, I feel like. Would be a nice touch. A little garlic as well. And again, a little sprinkle of the Old Bay. Looking pretty good to me, but I wanna get it a little more crisp. See if we got a nice little crisp here. There we go. That's what I like to see. A nice little true crisp. That's what I'm looking for. What do y'all think of that? Pretty nice and beautiful and crispy looking, yeah? Do I get an approval from the south? Hope so. Think so. Okay, let's plate up a few dishes. All right, first dish. Let's go ahead and go where we just left off. Crispy potatoes with the beans. Crispy onions, nice, beautiful, personal plate of those. Want to treat this like a little family style tapas meal. I assume that's what you do in the South. Everybody comes over for a little family style something something. Bring in this beautiful cabbage dish, the bacon, the onion, the sausage. The green pepper. Gotta get some extra bacon in there. That looks very, very delicious and quite catching to the eye. Oh, plating issue. Next up, our egg noodles. Nice, just kind of warm with butter. I got the sauce bubbling away over here. Come in with a nice drizzle. That mushroom and beef. Hit it with a little more sauce. All around town. I think I definitely could have put a little more or a little less of the broth in the sauce. Kept it a little thicker, but for the most part, she good. All right, and there it is. Three plates. Let's look at them. The beef stroganoff, potatoes, beans, onions, and our southern cabbage. Let's get into this. All right, yo, what up? Welcome to today's subscriber, sponsor, and request. Coming in hot, like I said, Tanya Eller. Big shout out to you down in Georgia. Wish I was there. The other day I put up on my Instagram that it feels like minus 39 degrees Celsius where I am right now, and we've been in a polar vortex for like 2 weeks now. It's just been brutal. So appreciate the fact that you live in a hot place because it's not nice here. Also, big shout out to Bentley Justice, her son, 9-year-old son. He watches some Black Hoodie in his spare time. Heard he's a big fan. So shout out to you, man. Thank you for watching, both of you guys. And I'm interested to try this food. I mean, you know, I'm familiar with all the ingredients pretty much, aside from the, like, I know what lima beans are, but never really eat them. But everything else is like in my repertoire. I've just never had these combinations of food, and I've never cooked these before. So please give me a slight little pass if I've messed anything up too bad. But I think the worst thing that happened was the stroganoff, just the sauce split a little bit. But we'll see. This will be like a nice little flavor adventure for me taste buds. So before doing anything more, we must pour. And I don't know what you guys drink down there, but all I had was Dr. Pepper. Suppose I should have brought some sweet tea to the mix here. But I've got a nice, really cold, half-frozen bottle of Dr. Pepper. I cranked up my beverage fridge to like almost the highest setting. So now that when I put drinks in there, they come out in like a half, like frosty, slushy type thing. It's really great. Super enjoyable. But first sip on this, and then we go. Delicious. So yeah, I just wanted to lay this out like a little family style jam. I feel like that would be kind of the vibe. You know, I feel like Southern cooking is definitely about like sharesies. So, you know, just family cookout vibe. So I actually want to try the beef stroganoff first, more than anything. Got the buttered egg noodles. Got that beautiful sauce. The mushrooms, the meat. I want to give you guys an up-close jam. It's very scary, and yep, that's why. All the eggs went down, and by that I mean noodles. Very delicious. I'm just trying to strategize a way to eat this. I feel like the spoon would almost be better. Mm-hmm. Mm. I know I've heard from people growing up over the years, like, it seems like a lot of families, like, stroganoff is a popular dish. I feel as if. I understand why. Who doesn't like everything that's in this right now? Rich, earthy, carbs. Wasn't a mainstay in my family. I know I've had it before, but probably a handful of times. I can understand why this would be on one of your favorites. I feel like these dishes aren't necessarily all that difficult. It's just like the prep component. And all like the cook the meat, separate it. Just takes patience. But this is obviously fantastic. If I can't stop eating it. Very, very good. If anything, it kind of reminds me of like, if you just had mushroom, cream of mushroom soup. with some beef in it and added it to egg noodles and then licked the plate. I love the sauce. It's that delicious. All right, where do we go next? I want to go here. This. I love cabbage. I don't eat it enough. Couldn't tell you why. But I do love it. Oh man. Oh wow. Going back to the spoon. Yo. That is home comfort food. In a nutshell. Don't play with me. Just that bite with so much bacon and wow. The cabbage is like so beautifully soft, but with like the slightest crunch. Salty, fatty. And the pepper and the Old Bay. A little hit of heat. This is a definite. Make again. Adding to my list of foods that I eat. Holy crap. Wasn't expecting it to be this good. Part of me also really wants to dunk like drizzle, just like a squirt of sour cream on each bite. Sour cream fiend. I know, my bad. Absolute banger. Absolute banger. Okay, for the last one. Should be good too, I believe. Crispy patat. What I think is gonna really stand out in this is the garlic. No, it's there, but it's not crazy overwhelming. Might have could have used a little more. Let me know when you do butter beans when I was cooking these, I first cut them in the pan. I was getting such a, just like a funky, almost Parmesan cheesy type smell. Is that normal with beans like this? I don't know. Beans usually, just fresh out of the can, give like a, you know, a little sulfury, stank bean. But these were different. I don't know. This feels like it's missing something for me. Because of the nature of it, and I'm such a sauce fiend, once again, I want like a dip. Just because it's like starchy overload. I want something just to sneak in there, add a new element. So that's one thing I would definitely change for myself. But man, that cabbage was something else. And the stroganoff, amazing too. All right, so that'll close that one there. Not the craziest, intense one today, but that was more of like a new food experience for me. I really wanted to be involved in the plates and understand what was happening in my mouth after having put in that effort to cook them. So, you know, I just wanted to kind of engage in that culture and the Southern culture and just see what that was really about in my mouth and understand why it's your favorite, like comfort meal, I guess. But once again, big shout out, Tanya, Justice, Bentley, and till the next one, you know what to do. Eat good, live well. Stay true.